Listen to me. You should be shunning this woman, not rewarding her with gifts. A baby shower for an unwed mother. Now I've heard it all. Who's next?
Ross, did your mother get here all right?
Yes. I'm begging you. We could drive a stake through that thing's heart right now.
Ross, please, trust me. My way is better. Ah, Mrs. Mulvern, I'm Dr. Frasier Crane. It's such a pleasure to meet you.
Oh, Dr. Crane, I can't thank you enough for finding me and bringing me here.
Well, I was so moved by your story. It's a joy to do this for you.
For 20 years, I've wondered where my little girl was and if I'd ever see her again.
What did you two fight about to begin with?
Oh, I blame myself. I thought the man she wanted to marry wasn't good enough for her, so she eloped. I've been so afraid the emphysema would finish me before I could ask her forgiveness and tell her I love her.
Well, tell her you shall, Ross.
Forget couples therapy, Allison. He is a loser. If you don't drop him right now, you deserve every bit of misery that you get. God bless, honey. Who's next?
We have Frasier Crane on line one.
Frasier, you want to yell at me for that last call?
No. Although I do believe that a gifted therapist can help two people put aside their anger and heal the differences between them.
Blah, blah, blah.
I have someone here with me today. Someone you haven't seen for quite a while. There's something she'd like to tell you. Something she's wanted to tell you for a very long, long time. Mrs. Mulvern.
You little whore!
Mother!
Oh, you thought you could get away from me, did you? Thought you could leave me to rot in a dump with a barely enough cash for a bottle of Matus? You'll pay for that, Missy.
I was wrong, Frasier. Your way is better.
Mrs. Mulvern!
Keep back of this!
Mother, please! I am doing my show!
Yes, you're a little Miss Perfect now, aren't you? Telling everybody else how wicked they are. They should hear about your past.
Mrs. Mulvern, please.
Shame you brought on me. You ungrateful trap.
Please, I'm a good girl now.
How you were paid to leave town by that nice boy's family.
For God's sake, Nora, go to commercial.
There, Seattle. Now you know what I mean when I say there are some people you just don't need in your life.
Help me out, George. I tell you here, I want my cut.
I knew that you hated me, but I just can't believe you could be so cruel.
I was trying to help. She seemed delightful on the phone.
I want $50 right now.
How many times will I have to move before I'm finally free of her?
Nora, I'm sorry.
You owe me, Missy.
Mrs.
I give you life.
I'll kill you.
Frasier, we've got dead air.
Hello. This is Dr. Frasier Crane. I'm sure Dr. Nora's listeners join me in hoping that she and her mother can resolve these differences very soon. They're off to a bit of a bumpy start. But at least the lines of communication are open.